second period. Jets have scored twice here. Meantime, at the blue line here, Sanford is getting all tangled up and into it with Corey Perry, and that's drawing a crowd.
Well, Perry was trying to go to the bench on a line change, and Sanford and he collided, and then they just kept wrestling back and forth, and neither one of them would let go. And here goes Corey. Perry's going to go with Sanford.
Yeah, he dropped the glove, said, "All right, enough, let's go."
This is good. This is what this line does. This is what Corey Perry does. It's what Pat Maroon does, and they need to turn something around here. They need to change the flavor of this game because it's turned against them, and sometimes this is what it takes. Corey Perry will stir things up as well as anybody in the National Hockey League, and he wasn't going to get pushed around here. We'll see what it does for the team. His hands. So this was all going on while the play is on the other side of the ice. Corey Perry's not going to let him get away, and then the whistle blew. And the rest is history at this point. But I'm good with that kind of play, that in-your-face kind of stuff. The Lightning needed some more of that. As I said, the game has turned against them, obviously, on the scoreboard. Winnipeg's feeling pretty good about themselves, and you can't have an opposing team feeling good about themselves in your barn.
Puck is slapped in by Ryan McDonagh. Hellebuck slowed it up in behind his net. Now it ends up in the near corner. Hagel is up there along with Anthony Cirelli. Puck rolls out in front and it's moved.